Preludio. The heavens open, and drive out the beloved angel, devoid of grace. His wings burn, and he falls into darkness. There is the Lord of Hell already awaiting the fallen angel and organized a masked ball in honor of him. At the ball, he invites the angel to become his right hand. The angel replies that he will never serve evil. The heavens open again and give the angel a chance to return, if as a mortal he can go through 9 circles of hell.
Thank you.
first circle of hell, the limbo. The gates of hell are opened and the angel takes the first step to the first circle of hell, limbo. Silence envelops and the whispers of the innocent, who are doomed to painless grief, follow him. One of the souls takes the form of a Buddhist and knocked down the angel, then another is a Hindu and third is a Muslim. They are angry. They lived a life of the righteous. Why did they end up in hell and heaven gave a chance to the angel, but not them? Suddenly the angel found himself in a blue luminous ball with a little girl, who saved him from angry souls. She said that if he could get out of hell, then they would have hope. The girl disappeared, and the angel went forward. He was quietly escorted by ghosts of the limbo. We'll be right back. The second circle of hell, the lust. The angel continued to go into darkness. Little red lights gradually began to appear. The angel followed them. Suddenly it became very light and the angel appeared on the road, which was surrounded by the souls of fornicators, praying for salvation. The guards came running and dispersed all the souls. A beautiful palace appeared. Four female figures headed for the palace. Three of them were handmaids who carried a veil hiding the fourth, their mistress. The angel decided to get into the palace to see her. The doors of the palace opened for the angel. Everything looked like in paradise. He went along the petals of red roses. This road led him directly to the mistress. He looked up and saw Cleopatra. They spun in wondrous dance and heart of the angel has never beat so strong. But he didn't know. The devil persuaded Cleopatra to seduce the angel and leave him forever in hell. And here as their lips almost merged in a kiss, but suddenly he remembered the little girl and the hope which he could give to her. At that moment the palace collapsed and became sinful souls. The souls turned in the red lights and the angel went into the darkness. the third circle of hell, the gluttony. Two ugly giants appeared from the emptiness. They approached closer and closer until their nasty bodies surrounded the angel. The giants have started to argue, who will eat in the angel? But a drop of rain fell on the forehead one of the giants and he ran. Then showers began and the second giant ran to the first. The angel couldn't understand why, but was happy. Not for long. The rain was so heavy that very soon it became the river which had flooded all around. The giants were so helpless and they drowned under the waves. The angel tried to resist. He saw a ship and swam to it. The captain noticed the angel and sent sailors to him. One of the giants got out and tried to drown the angel and leave him for forever in hell. But the sailors took the angel to the ship. The river has become a sea and then an ocean. The giants drowned in these waters and the ship with the angel went forward. The fourth circle of hell, the greed. The ocean was restless. Cleopatra sent three maids to take the angel. They turned into Undine and sailed for the ship. When the Undine caught up with the ship, they again turned into beautiful girls and went to lure the pirates with a dance. And now they are already dancing a waltz with the captain, trying to figure out where the angel is hidden. But the pirates have their own plans for the angel. They take him to the devil to receive all treasures of the ocean as a reward. The Undine realize that the pirates will not tell anything and drag them under the water, continuing to dance their waltz. While the Undine are busy with the pirates, the angel manages to get out of the sinking ship, boards the boat and sails away. The Undine didn't stop until they drowned all the pirates and their ship, but they themselves were left with nothing.
Thank you.
the fifth circle of hell, the swamp of anger. The angel sailed further and further. The water became dirty and rowing became harder until the boat got stuck in the mud. He couldn't continue to row, so climbed out of the boat and walked through the swamp. Lazy souls clung to him and he had to drag them along, also. The souls of the innocent from limbo that were angry with the angel, the devil sent them here so they wouldn't let him go any further. The souls pulled the angel down into the darkness, but he resisted. And the more he fought, the harder it became. The forces left the angel land. Evil souls from limbo just watched the torment of the angel, because lazy souls in this swamp are like loose sands in the desert. Finally, the angel understood what to do. He just stopped moving as if dead and the lazy souls let him go and retreated. The angel rose again, but the evil souls couldn't let him go so easily, but couldn't touch too, because we're not from here. So the souls decided to scare the angel and leave him here. The angel understood everything and continued on his way, despite the persecution and threats of evil souls. The sixth circle of hell, the ghosts and the burning rage. Fire. Fire enveloped everything around. Graves burning from the fire are everywhere. Screams and groans came from the graves. The ghosts of heretics, false prophets and teachers always burn there, and the angel decided to help. He opened one of the graves, burning his hands. A ghost appeared in front of the angel, engulfed in flames, and he said that was unfairly here. He only had own opinion and tried to give people a choice. The choice of what to believe. For this, the ghost is doomed to burn forever in the flame of God's wrath. But no. Now the angel will serve his sentence. The ghost pushed the angel into his grave and closed it. The angel screamed in pain. The red-hot grave was like a frying pan that burned his skin. Meanwhile, the ghost followed to left, but his walk didn't last long. Furies, the guardians of the sixth circle of hell, quickly found the fugitive. They sent him to its rightful place, instead of the angel. The Furies didn't care about the angel. Their job is only to be guardians for their prisoners. The seventh circle of hell, the 14th. A dark room without windows and doors. The lonely girl lies against the wall, knowing that every moment can be the last. The angel tried to approach the girl to help, but she cried out so that he wouldn't touch her, because no one could save her. She made her choice. The girl began to tell a story of how she became one of the victims of the serial killer, who killed 39 girls and went unpunished. To stop the maniac, she had to kill herself. After that, he went crazy and was caught. All 39 girls went to heaven, but the 14th must live this day in hell, along with the killer. Every minute he can burst into the room, there is no time. The girl took a splinter of the mirror. At that very moment the angel ran to her and that splinter of the mirror pierced his chest. A beam of light illuminated the room. The girl said thanks. The angel managed to save her soul and she went to heaven. Thank you. circle of hell, the fate. Three fireflies appeared in the darkness, which surrounded a wounded angel. He tried to catch one of them and the firefly turned into a young girl. The girl was in white. She spun a golden thread in which the angel saw his whole life in one instant. The angel didn't notice how a gypsy woman in red appeared on the spot of a young girl. She began to confuse the golden thread, talk about the present and predict the future of the angel. Suddenly the gypsy became an old woman in black. She stared silently at the bleeding angel. In her hands was a fading thread and gold scissors. The old woman delivered her verdict, having uttered only one word: death. She simply disappeared with the thread in her hands. For some reason, the old woman didn't cut the golden thread of the life of an angel, but her fateful verdict remained in his thoughts. The Ninth Circle of Hell, the Versus. Gloom and cold. Only the whisper of spirits that glide on the icy lake is heard. With each step they are getting closer to the angel until suddenly everything around becomes bright and beautiful like in paradise. There are many souls around, in smiling masks. They lead the angel. He feels this is wrong, then tears off the mask from the leader and sees the devil. The illusion collapses and all souls take off their masks. Souls from all over hell are advancing. The devil orders the angel to surrender and become his right hand. The angel replies that he will not. The devil repeats his proposal, and the angel rejects it again. The devil offers one last time, but the answer of the angel is unchanged. In this case, the devil reports that only death and oblivion are destined for the angel. The angel said, "Let it be." the fallen angel, Ultimo. Divine light illuminates everything around, the angel at home in heaven. All heavenly angels and saints greet him with a standing ovation. On his way to the golden gate of paradise, the angel looks back and remembers what he had to go through to get here. Then he makes a decision. The angel asks heaven to send him to earth and help mortals resist the sins that will lead them to hell. Then heavenly forces lift the angel into the air and pierce him with an incinerating beam. The angel became ash. One speck of dust turns into a spark. Then another. More and more until these sparks begin to make their way through the heavens and fall into space. Sparks join each other and gain speed. Soon they form a giant ball of fire that rushes directly to the earth. Collision is inevitable. When the ball of fire touched the earth, it disappeared, and at that moment a beautiful girl was born in its crater.
Thank you. Thank you.